Big John Studd, last individual to be introduced, and without a doubt, I would think Lord Alfred Hayes, the odds-on favorite to win this battle royal.
Well, I tell you, I was watching every man as they came into the ring, Vince, and I have never been so impressed by physical conditioning ever. John Studd would have a mighty task on his hands there if two or three were to gang up on him.
I would think that might be the strategy, as they're all going for one another in the battle royal, of course. Bear in mind, it is a free-for-all. And a number of individuals likely to team up on Big John Studd first, get the big man over the top rope, and then things even out a little bit.
Yes, and I would imagine that there's several men here who have nothing but revenge on their mind for torture they were put through in the hands of Studd in single matches.
Then again, in a battle royal, and who's going to go over? Somebody! Charlie Fulton almost over. Oh, Moondog Spot over there to bring him back in, I believe. Mm-hmm. Trying to get him back over. No. Seesaw as to whether or not he's going to go over. No, he's back on his feet. Moondog hammering in to beat Brian Blair. Now things evening up all the way around the squared circle there.
Yes, every man is trying, of course, to win this big prize here. And what a feather in their cap to win such a battle royal as this.
That's Joe Myrtle, the first man over. Tony Atlas could very well be the second. Johnny Rods, I believe. Yes.
He looks very
every
much
man
like
for
it.
Himself, and there's no telling who will win the battle royal on many an occasion. It's the underdog that comes out on top.
So we've had one man eliminated so far, Vince Myrtle. And of course, Fulton was very, very close to going out.
And that's hey. Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. Triple teamed, I think, there moments ago.
Yeah, I think that must have been an omen when you said he was nearly out before, and it was actually Rods. Neidhart with his back to us there, struggling. Marino.
Mr. Marino.
He's gone. So already we've got three eliminated.
A whole bunch, actually, as now things are starting to thin out a little bit in the battle royal. Mm-hmm. Wow, did you see that? Charlie Fulton right over.
Woo! And that was from Neidhart. I think that was Neidhart gave him a very heavy, hard right hand and sailed him clean over the ropes.
Big John Studd back to the corner. Up on top now is Johnny Rods, and Rods hammering with a series of right hands. Maybe to soften up the big man. Waddy's still all over the place in the squared circle.
John Studd taking his toll on Johnny Rods there.
Who is that that just went over? It's the Axe who just went over the top rope.
I missed that one. I was watching another part of the action. Everything is happening here. Spoiler in the middle of the ring there, making his presence felt.
And George Wells hanging in there as well. Ivan Putski, the Polish power, doing extremely well. And also a favorite to win this battle royal. Oh, look at that, the spoiler over the top. Putski ducked the right hand. The momentum took the spoiler right over. So again, things continue to thin out, and Big John Studd is almost out. Look at this. The big man's going out. There are three of them over there. Yes. Oh, yeah. Big John Studd is out, and he is angry. Boy, is he angry.
He is. He tried to take everybody with him, and he couldn't manage it.
Took a few individuals with him. I think he took Putski.
Yes.
So right now, things really thinning out in there. B. Brian Blair, along with David Sammartino, the Moondog.
Neidhart.
And, look at this now. Bret Hart. Ooh, my. Bret Hart on the top rope there, being attacked from behind. B. Brian Blair is a moment ago by the Anvil, Neidhart. Jim Neidhart. Ooh, into the back. We've seen many times the tag team combination of the Anvil, Jim Neidhart, along with Bret Hart. And they, I think, are definitely the odds-on favorite right now to win this battle royal. Bruno Sammartino's son, David, in the squared circle, along with B. Brian Blair. Just those four individuals, that's all it's down to now. Out of 16, we're down to four, and that's heart to heart. Ooh.
That was a real close. I'm surprised that they were able to do a thing like that to the heart combination.
It's not over yet. Now the hearts are in bad shape. As Sammartino. Look at that. Nice maneuver on the part of Bret Hart. David Sammartino with a forearm to the back of Bret Hart. A knee to the side and the head.
both the Hart men, now Neidhart and Hart, of course, trying to establish themselves as a team.
They've done extremely well in tag team competition throughout the World Wrestling Federation. Many contend that they are. Oh, look at this! David, no, from behind. What's happening here? Aha! Now, is Bret Hart, did he go over the top? Is he out of it? Maybe not. I think he went through the second rope.
I think he did. I think he came back in. And
there's
David
very little
nothing.
Hope now for B. Brian Blair. He's holding his own, but probably only for a moment. Both Harts in there, Neidhart and Bret Hart. Hammering away on B. Brian Blair.
This is where that conditioning comes in, Vince.
It's also where Lady Luck comes in, but it looks like the luck has run out on B. Brian Blair. He might do well to jump over the top rope, save himself the trouble. This tag team is really a devastating combination. Bret Hart and the Anvil Jim Neidhart. And look at him, they're just playing around with B. Brian Blair in there at the moment.
Yes, they're not only awesome, they're vicious as well.
A legal double team. One of the few times you'll see a legal double team, but you have it here in this special 16-man over-the-top rope battle royal. Watch this now. Blair coming up. Oh, my, forget about it.
They've got him now exactly as they want him.
Just a matter of time before B. Brian Blair is catapulted over the top rope. Full Nelson. Clyde, and here comes Bret Hart. Oh, no. He just went over. Bret Hart drop kicked the Anvil Jim Neidhart, and he just barely went over the top rope. Now it's one-on-one. B. Brian Blair and Bret Hart. To the buckle goes Bret Hart. Blair charges right on target, hammering away on Bret Hart. And the Hitman not doing well for himself right now. Blair has him halfway up. Up. Almost over. Almost over. Oh, look at that. Oh, my.
He really took a hit to the side.
He really did, yes. Into the head. Wait a minute. Now this man's been eliminated. The Anvil Jim Neidhart should vacate the premises. He's been eliminated.
There's a referee standing outside the ring to do that, but I don't think he wants to leave.
Meanwhile, it's one-on-one, and as you can see, things have reversed for B. Brian Blair. David Sammartino likewise hanging around the outside of the ring. So Blair, the underdog, certainly one of the underdogs coming into this battle royal. I don't think he could, well, maybe you could say the same for Bret Hart. Two underdogs going at it in there, and one of them's going to be victorious here very, very shortly and win this prestigious 16-man over the top rope battle royal. And look at this, it's going to be Blair on the outside. Hart has him up, up, oh, just inches from going over. Just, no, oh my, just inches.
Just could not make it, didn't have quite enough strength there. As a matter of fact, Blair looking very tired, but I think he may have a little left in the bag, more than Bret Hart.
Blair going
possible.
Downstairs now, trying to assert himself. Oh my, is he ever. Not an awful lot behind those punches, though. But enough to bat. Oh, look at this. Both men had the same idea. But now it's Bret Hart in control once again. Back to the middle of the ring. Oh, my. That'll take the starch right out of you.
Gosh, that was a reverse knee drop there. And that really has floored Blair.
The calf striking the back of the head of B. Brian Blair. Nice maneuver on the part of young Bret Hart. And Bret Hart, it appears, just moments away from winning this special battle royal. Blair now whipped to the ropes. Oh, my. What an elbow smash.
Big, big back elbow. That could be the curtains for Blair here. He's struggling hard to get back to his feet.
I don't understand this. Hart, over, I believe, having a few words with David Sammartino moments ago. Apparently, sensing victory, Bret Hart, a moment ago, a little too overconfident. Right now, he has reason for confidence. He is in control. Ooh, my. Blair with a forearm, knocked him flat as a pancake. Almost a desperation move for B. Brian Blair, knocking Bret Hart flat as a pancake just moments ago.
What resilience Blair has.
Blair, as well as Bret Hart, have proven themselves in this battle royal to be two of the premier athletes in the World Wrestling Federation. Boom! What a close! Brian Blair. Again, attesting to the craftiness of Bret Hart, the Hitman, turning him over now and dropping the elbow. Again, loosening up, softening up B. Brian Blair. What a battle this has been. Both men, regardless of who wins this battle royal, both men deserve a tremendous amount of credit. Again, Bret Hart distracted by David Sammartino.
Look out.
Drop kick over the top rope. That's it. B. Brian Blair has won the 16-man over the top rope battle royal. There is jubilation here.
Blair made that a magnificent effort right at the end there. Bret Hart turned his back on him.
Let's get the official announcement. Oh, but look at this. No, the microphone goes back up and the action continues. The match officially over. Blair, with the anvil there in the corner, trying to haul him out. He won't go anywhere. Now the two hearts. Oh, my, what a reversal. Finally, outside the ring, the anvil. Jim Neidhart, along with Hitman Bret Hart, his tag team partner. But there, you see two very happy individuals. David just as happy, I believe, as if he had won the match.
The winner of the Battle Royal and $10,000, B. Brian Blair.
What a sensational Battle Royal. B. Brian Blair, and I guess Mr. Blair, very, very lucky. Certainly one of the underdogs coming in here into this Battle Royal, but certainly you have to give him a great deal of credit for his extraordinary physical prowess. Let's take another look here at what we saw earlier. The Hitman right on top of him, Bret Hart. It was a seesaw matchup after it got down to these two men all the way. Big John Studd eliminated earlier on. Certainly the overwhelming favorite. There again, you see David Sammartino distracting Bret Hart. And that allowed this to happen. Oh, my. Imagine the feeling and what the thoughts going through the mind of the Hitman Bret Hart. He almost won this battle royal. But there you see the victor. B. Brian Blair being congratulated by David Sammartino. What a sensational 16-man over-the-top rope battle royal.